I develop new medicines and therapies to help patients get better. I am mainly focused on developing new medicines to treat cancer, to treat Alzheimer's, Parkinson's disease, Lou Gehrig's disease, really devastating diseases that affect not just the patients, but their families as well, who have to take care of them. I decided to do this, develop new drugs, because I always wanted to be a physician. I always wanted to be a doctor. Ever since I was a little boy, I was age 9, and realized that being a doctor would be just a really cool thing to do. I got to help people. I got to do science, which I loved. It was always just that thing that I knew I was supposed to do. I was 9 years old when I learned that I wanted to be a doctor. It just dawned on me that it would be a wonderful way to help people. And when I was 9 years old, that was the thing that I wanted to do. When I was a teenager, I was actually a little nerdy. I loved science, I loved math. I loved figuring out really tough problems, and I tried to understand how I could take all those things that I thought I was really good at and put them together in a way that would be meaningful, that would help people, that would do something different in this world. And I found medicine and healthcare and taking care of people as the best expression of how I could do what I do best. I got the idea of taking care of people. I guess it came from the fact that I grew up in a religious household, and thinking about others was always really important in our household. And I think I just adopted that. I took it in. It became a part of who I am, and it became really important. I actually, as a little boy, thought anything was possible for my life. Maybe it was the love of my parents, maybe it was the education I had, but I always knew I could do whatever I wanted. I never worried that I couldn't do something. That was probably the most freeing thing that I had as a kid. When I was 10 years old, I think success for me was getting an ice cream cone at the end of school and getting, I don't know, to play basketball. I think I'm different now. I think I believe that success really doesn't define the person. The person defines success. I think if you're thinking about success and what makes success, there are so many things that society wants us to believe: money, fame, great opportunities, travel, cars, all of these things. But those are all of the things outside that don't really define who we are as a person. And if we can find that center of who we are, the core of who we are, we can then define what our success is.